In this video, we're going to talk about some very basic Unix commands for navigating the file system. And we're going to look at the basic file commands that let you change directories, print what actual directory you're currently in, and also see files in the directory that you're currently in. So let's start with pwd, or print working directory. Pwd is a command that allows you to see what directory you're currently in. And you'll notice that according to this, I'm in /home/json. So anytime you need to see where you currently are, use pwd. Next up, we want to look at the ls command, which allows us to see what's in our current directory. So the ls command by itself will show me a series of files. And you can think of ls as standing for list. And what you'll notice is currently with this terminal, there are some color-coded words in front of me. Anything that is blue is a directory. Anything that is white is a standard folder. You won't always have a color-coded terminal available to you. So what would you do if you didn't have a color-coded terminal available to you? Well, what you could do is you could start to pass some options to the ls command. So the first thing we could do is we could do an ls-l. And ls-l gives me a long listing of all of the files in this directory. And you'll notice that it does so, it gives me all the files in a vertical orientation. And everything's still color-coded. But one of the things that you'll notice is now there's this large jumble of characters over here on the left-hand side of the screen. And I will highlight down, and you'll notice that every one of these blue highlighted pieces of text is actually a directory. So the first letter in this jumble of characters, if you see the letter D, is a directory. If you see a dash, it's just a regular plain text file. We'll talk more about what all of this means in terms of the ls-l listing in a future lecture, but for now we just want to focus on utilizing the ls-l command, well, the ls command with the -l option. So what are some other options that you might want to do with ls? Well, all those files that we're looking at aren't actually all the files. So I'm going to do ls-a, which says show me all the files. And what you'll notice is that -a shows me much more information than just plain -ls, plain ls and plain ls-l. What you'll notice is that now I see a number of files that start with a dot. One cool feature in Unix is that if you want to hide a file from regular directory listings, is you just make sure that the file name starts with a dot. So the reason why you don't see the dot bash logout file is because it starts with a dot. Basically, by putting a dot as the first character in a name, it's like saying, only show this to me if I specifically ask to see it. It doesn't mean the file's hidden. It just means that, and it's top secret and nobody can get to it. It just means people won't see it without using the -a option. Another cool feature is that we can chain options together with commands. So we can actually do -la. And if we do -la, you'll notice that now I get all of the files in the directory in a long listing format. Okay, very cool. I'm going to use the clear command to reset my terminal. You may have just asked, why did I just type ls-la without doing -l-a? Well, let's see if that works. And notice it does. Okay, so you have a couple options here. You can either combine the l and the a behind a single dash, or you can separate them out. I would say that most people do not separate them like I just showed you, but I wanted to mention that. So I'm going to hit clear again. You may have just noticed that I was magically able to see all of the commands that I previously typed. This is a feature of the bash shell called, basically it gives you a way to navigate your history. And as I hit the up arrow key, you'll notice that I can go through my most recent commands. And if I scroll the down arrow key, I'll go back through to the commands that I was just executing. So we can use the arrow keys to go up and down through our history. So I'm going to choose ls-l from what I previously did and just kind of go back to save a little bit of typing. So those are two features. I was going to do -lh. And you'll notice that in this case, -lh, the h stands for human. And H actually shows file sizes in kilobytes and megabytes. What did it show before? I hit the up arrow key to get back to my command and take out the H. And you'll notice that I get, these are basically in bytes. So I think most humans think in kilobytes and megabytes as opposed to bytes. So I like the H command. So these are a couple of basic commands or basic options that you can perform with the ls command. What? How would you find out more? Well, look at the man page. And if you look at the ls man page, what you're going to notice is that there are any number of commands that you might want to utilize for dealing with ls information. And you can read this on your own. And we'll talk some more about different ls options in the future. So we just looked at a couple of new commands. We looked at ls. We looked at clear, because you notice when I typed that, it cleared my terminal window. We looked at pwd to see our working directory. And we actually just looked at the man command. And depending on what order you're watching these videos in, it might be the first time you've seen the ability to use the man command. And I'll talk about more about that in another video lecture. I'll also talk a little bit more about where these previously executed commands come from when you hit the up and down arrow key. So the next step we would need to look at is, how do we change directories? And the command that we use to change directories is cd. And we're going to need to use our knowledge of absolute and relative paths for the cd command. So I'll do a print working directory. I'm currently in /home/json. I want to see what's in that directory. So I think what I'm going to do is I want to change my directory and go into the desktop directory. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to type cd space desktop. And the way this works is you type cd and then the name of the directory that you want to go to. This is a relative path. This says I'm currently in the directory JSON, and in that directory is a directory called desktop, and I want to go down into that directory. I hit enter, and if I type pwd, you'll see that I've now gone down into the desktop directory. What if I want to go back up to the JSON directory? Well, there's actually a shortcut for that, and a couple of different directories have shortcut names. The directory above you is called dot dot. So if I want to go back up one step, I type dot dot, and I've now just gone back up a step. If I want to go up to the home directory, I can say cd dot dot, and now I'm back up to the home directory. I want to go up to the root directory, cd dot dot, now I'm in the root directory. Can I go any higher? Nope, because I'm in the root directory. What if I want to go back down? Well, I could do an ls and go into home and then ls again and go into JSON and then go ls into desktop if I wanted to go to desktop. But let's say I just want to go to my home directory. If you just type cd without any arguments, it takes you home, which is really nice. If I want to go to the root directory again, I can just type cd slash, because that's actually an absolute path. And that's going to take me back up to the top of the root directory. Now, what I can do when I'm here, and what I wanted to demonstrate, is there's two ways you can get your home directory. You can type cd, or you can type cd tilde. Tilde is a basically an alias within your shell for your home directory. And so you'll notice when I type that, I end up back in my home directory. So cd by itself, or cd with a tilde, will always take you home. We'll see where that tilde comes in handy in when we get to scripting and in a couple other places. So the other, next thing we could do is we could look at, you know, kind of how do we go somewhere else on the system. And if you notice, I'm currently sitting in my home directory, but let's say I want to go up to see what's in this bin directory. Well, if I want to change my directory, I could type cd slash bin. I can now use an absolute path. Remember, any path that starts with the root directory is absolute, because it says go to the top level of the data hierarchy and step down into the directory name that I give you. And now I'm in the slash bin directory. I want to go home, type cd. And so there's a lot of ways to get around the file system using the command line. A couple other things that are important to note. Right, again, I'm in my home directory. Let's say I want to see everything that's in the bin directory. Well, I could do ls slash bin, and there's everything in the slash bin directory. Notice I can see what's in the slash bin directory without having to change my directory or cd into that directory. What happens if I leave off the slash? What if I type ls bin? I get an error, and it says, hey, there is no such file or directory. And because I left off that preceding slash, in other words, I left off the root directory, what happens is the ls command looks in my current directory for a directory called bin. And since there is no directory called bin in my home directory, I have nowhere to go. Let's compare what I'm doing side by side. Right now on the left, I have a terminal, and I am currently in my home directory. On the right, I have a GUI representation of the file system, and I'm in my home directory. Say I want to go down into the documents directory. I just double click. On the command line, I say cd documents. And now I'm in the documents directory. Let's say I want to go back up to my home directory. Okay, in this case, I can click on home here. I can click on home here. I could hit the back arrow. On the command line, I say cd dot dot. Let's say I want to keep going up. And again, in Ubuntu, I can get back up to the root of the drive by kind of clicking this little left arrow here until I see a drive, and I can go to bin. Well, if I want to do that from my command line, I just say cd slash bin. So this is just a quick introduction to the process of navigating directories. We talked a little bit about changing up and down directories using absolute and relative paths, looked a little bit at how to determine what directory we're current in, looked at some shortcuts for directory names. I will add one more shortcut. If two dots means go up, one other thing that you'll find is a single dot represents the current directory. So if I say cd dot, I don't go anywhere because it's like saying change directory to the current directory. So dot is also another shortcut that we can utilize and we will utilize in future exercises for representing directories. Hopefully this is helpful. The only real way to learn this is to just play with it and maybe do a setup I have here with the visual graphical interface on the right and your command line on the left and try to figure out how to jump from one directory to another.